Okay, we're going to shift gears a little bit now, just for a few minutes, and talk about phrasing. This is something that we pay more attention to in this style than we have in previous styles, and it has a lot to do with the kind of song-like structure that we're heading towards. So we're starting to think about a memorable melody, more so than we had when we were just doing first, second, third, and fourth species counterpoint. So we start to think about something called the phrase. Now, the phrase you can think about as analogous to a sentence in language. Okay, so a phrase is kind of like a single sentence. It has a beginning, a middle, and an end. And it can end, well, it always ends with some kind of cadence. And you can think about that. You can think of that as the punctuation at the end of a sentence. If it is a perfect, authentic cadence, then it's kind of the same as having the period at the end of a sentence, right? I went to the store. Period. Perfect, authentic cadence right there. Or it can have an imperfect, authentic cadence or even a deceptive cadence, in which case it would be like having a question mark at the end of a sentence, right? So something like, did you go to the store? Perfect or imperfect cadence at the end there. So there's no a lot of I remember a lot of students ask when we start looking at phrases, how long is a phrase? Like how many bars? And there's not a clear-cut answer for that. That kind of depends on the style of music. It depends on the song in particular. If you really wanted a number, you could say between it's either 4 or 8 bars is kind of the ballpark we're looking at, but you can have odd-numbered phrases. You can have much longer phrases than that. You can have short phrases than that. It all depends on kind of the piece and how you're looking at it. Another aspect of phrasing that we need to think about is something that we're just going to call the basic phrase. The basic phrase starts in what we'll call a tonic area. That means, like in this example we have on the screen here, if we're in the key of F, we're going to start around F. And when we're talking about something called an area, I would call this whole measure in the area of F. There are three different chords here, but they all work in F. The other area that we need to head to is the dominant area. This I would call is in the dominant area. So if it's not in the dominant area, it's probably in the tonic area. So in the basic phrase, we have an opening area that's in the tonic area, a bunch of stuff that happens around tonic. And then we have a middle area that's a bunch of stuff that happens around dominant. And then we have a closure area that's again in tonic with a little bit of a cadence at the end of it. So tonic, dominant, tonic. Sometimes abbreviated TDT, tonic, dominant, tonic. And that is the structure of our basic phrase. So one more time. Basic phrase means we're going to start something in tonic area, we're going to move to a dominant area, and then we're going to come back to a tonic area with a cadence at the end. That is what we call the basic phrase. Now, as we work with the basic phrase, we need to, there's a couple things we can do to talk about establishing tonic, the tonic area, and making that really feel like it's the tonic area that moves away in the middle section of the phrase to a dominant area and then establishes the dominant area and then comes back to that tonic area. So let's talk about that in the next couple of videos, establishing tonic and dominant areas.